Hey guys, how you doing? Quick video on coilovers with progressive springs. Would I recommend them? Short answer, no, I wouldn't. And here's why. The biggest reason, in my opinion, to fit coilovers is for the stability that you get from the springs that you get in them. Basically, linear springs is what I say is a coilover spring, what I believe is what should be on a coilover. And the reason I want a linear spring is because when I turn the wheel, the suspension loads up, you know, effectively instantly, rather than with progressive springs where you get a bit of body roll as the spring compresses before the suspension has settled under the load. And, you know, that obviously is not great, especially as the speeds get picked up. But a big problem with it is in fast direction changes. If you can imagine that, you know, you're waiting for the suspension to go that way, but if you're only turning for a fraction of a second and then you're going to turn the other way, there's potential for big instability to be put into the suspension solely because of the springs. I'm talking extreme usage here, yeah? The only reason I'd be getting coilovers is to get rid of that body roll. Is it the correct thing to do for a road car? That is a completely different video. But I'm just saying why I would fit coilovers and why I should think they should have linear springs, and it is because of that. Because I would only fit coilovers to get rid of progressive springs, because I want that iron fist control of the body. I want stability at all costs, and comfort comes second. If I'm going from progressive springs on the car to a progressive spring coilover, I'm not getting a solution to my problem, which is, you know, the body roll. For me, it defeats the point. What I would do though, I would go with your usual suspects, i.e. H&R or IBAC lowering springs. They'll get me all the stability I can realistically expect while still maintaining a comfortable car. Those springs, the H&R lowering springs, the IBAC lowering springs, completely negate the point in buying a coilover system that has progressive springs, in my opinion. And usually, when you see coilovers with progressive springs, usually they also have fixed damping, which for me is just the worst of all worlds. It's a coilover with the progressive spring, and it's a coilover where I can't adjust the damping, which is completely pointless. Why do they exist? Maybe some people think that, you know, a coilover, it's race, therefore it's better. It isn't really. Maybe it's better if it is a race suspension you put on your old car, and then you do arguably increased the limits of your car. But if you fitted a coilover kit with a progressive springs, you haven't done anything there over uprated lowering springs. And if you fit in a set of coilovers without damping adjustment, you're just giving yourself possibly uncomfortable suspension that you don't want to live with. So, you know, there are cheap kits out there. The ones that jump to mind are sort of JOM and FK. They're super cheap. They're like 200 quid, 220 euro, 240 euro for a coilover that has a progressive spring and it's got fixed damping. Why? The only reason I can think that you would buy that is for looks only. It gives you the height adjustment, so possibly you can put the car extremely low, which is a complete no-no for me. Maybe I'll do another video on ride heights. It's just for looks. For me, like I said, completely pointless. Fundamentally, the coilover is great because it's a race suspension, i.e. it gives ultimate stability. But if you're going to start compromising that stability by putting fixed damping and putting progressive springs on it, then, you know, what is the point in fitting the coilovers in the first place, you know? Posing? I don't know. So guys, that was it basically. Would I buy coilovers with progressive springs? The answer is absolutely not. So a bit of a ranty video. But as always, if you made it this far, thank you for watching. If you've got any comments, if you agree with what I'm saying, if you don't agree with what I'm saying, if your experience is different, feel free, leave a comment below. I'd love to hear other people's opinions on this. Obviously, there's no black and white answer. A lot of it comes down to personal preference. I'd love to know what you think. So as always, like I said, thank you for watching the video. Subscribe if you're not a subscriber. If you are a subscriber, thank you very much for subscribing to the channel. Look after yourself and I'll see you again next time.